Hi, I'm Daphne, and welcome to my Yin Yoga YouTube channel. So today's practice will be foundational, pretty simple, not a lot of complexity. It's important for you to remember to relax your muscles. We're trying to get into the deeper tissues in the body, connective tissues, the fascia, that webbing in your body that literally holds you together, supports your bones and your muscles and your organs. And breathe. We'll begin in a seated position with some breath work. You can either take this antler position, maybe you're sitting on top of a block, or if you prefer, you can come into a cross-legged position. Maybe you sit yourself up on a blanket. You will need a blanket, at least one blanket, and a bolster, a couple or a few blocks, depending on what you normally use in your yin yoga practice. If you don't have any of these items, you can certainly use things that you have in your house, pillows, books, blankets. If you want more suggested ways that you can utilize those items in your house to make some makeshift props, I have another YouTube video that you can watch. It's just about 3 minutes that'll help you try to figure out how to use the things that you have in your home to create some props for you. Okay, so let's begin your cross-legged or your antler position, sitting on your heels. Close your eyes. Take a deep inhale through the nose and a slow exhale through the nose. Inhale through the nose, one, two, three, four, and hold, one, two. Exhale through the nose, one, two, three, four, and pause, one, two. Again, inhale, one, two, three, four, and hold, one, two. Exhale, one, two, three, four, pause, one, two. And again, inhale, one, two, three, four, and hold, one, two. Exhale, one, two, three, four, pause, one, two. Continue on your own for just a few more rounds. Begin to settle into your breath. Start to notice the feelings that you have in your body, where you might be holding on to some tension, places of tightness. And then notice your state of mind. See if you can begin to distance yourself from whatever activities you were involved in before you came to your floor or your mat, and avoiding the temptation to plan or to think about anything that you have to do afterwards. The next time that you get to the pause after you exhale, the next time that you inhale, slowly begin to open your eyes and come to a normal breath rhythm. Good. So if you're in your antler position, you'll want to come out and take a cross-legged for a moment. Settle yourself on top of a blanket so that you can get your hips raised and your pelvis tilting forward as we move into some forward folds. So straighten both legs out in front of you, and we'll begin with a half butterfly position. Bring the right foot somewhere along the inside of your left leg. And here, play around a little bit with where you've positioned your right foot. So maybe you move it a little bit closer into your body. Perhaps you move it a bit further away. Sometimes I like to just slide my ankle underneath the knee of my left leg in this position. If your hip is feeling tight on the right side, you feel like you can't really relax into this, maybe place a block underneath the right thigh, the right knee, and then take an inhale, lift and lengthen from your tailbone all the way up through the crown of your head. And as you exhale, start to draw the upper body forward. Make sure that your legs are relaxed. Keep some length in your spine as long as it feels comfortable. And then let your upper body go. Release, let it round if it needs to. If you feel like you need some additional support, maybe you drag your bolster or a couple of blankets in front of you to rest your arms on, either vertically extending away from your body, or maybe you take it horizontal on top of the left leg, and in this case, on top of the dog that happens to be sitting next to your left leg. So you decide what makes the most sense for you. And then once you've made your adjustments, nuanced or otherwise, come back into your breath and settle into your pose. Feels sensations in their bodies differently as you're coming into your shape. And so you may feel this somewhere along the outer right hip or the outer right thigh. You may feel this along the back of your left leg. You may feel some sensation in the lower back. Most important is to relax as much as you can. And always remember that if you feel something sharp or stabbing, feels kind of nervy or electric, this is usually an indication that you've moved a bit too deep into your pose. So you just back off a little bit, give your body some time to settle in and ease into your sensation. Your body begins to become more accustomed to what you're feeling, you might decide that you move a little bit deeper into your pose. So maybe you inch your upper body forward a little bit. Maybe you get rid of whatever prop you might be using. Maybe you decide that you need a different type of support for your body. and take a deep inhale and a slow, complete exhale. And inhale to rise slowly out of your half butterfly. And then we're going to take that shape over to the opposite side. So you straighten your right leg in front of you, and then you'll fold your left leg in front of you. And again, decide how you want to position your left foot. Experiment a little bit with sensation as you move it along the inside of your right leg. Decide whether you might need something to support the right hip, or the left hip in this case. Take an inhale to lift and lengthen. Relax your legs. Draw the upper body forward, and then let your upper body relax. And as you come into this, you'll start to recognize where you might need support, if you need support. So make your adjustments. Take as much time as you need to at the beginning of your pose so that you can settle in for some stillness, and then come back to your breath. Configurations that you can do with your props. So experimentation is essential as you try to figure this out. Focus may be where all of the sensation you're feeling is in your body. But don't remember, do remember. I'm new at this. Lots of bloops are going to happen along the way here. But what I want to remind you of is that it's important to also remember that your upper body and the muscles in your face, around your eyes, in your jaw, in the throat, your neck and your shoulders, should also be soft as well. And that's what the props can help with. Thank you. take a deep inhale and exhale slowly. And inhale to rise slowly out of your half butterfly. So I just want to clarify that last statement that I made. New at filming online, not new at teaching or doing the practice. Take yourself out of your half butterfly and come into full butterfly. Bring the soles of your feet together and make sure that your props are accessible. So here again with the position of the feet, you decide what works for you. If you move the feet closer into your body, you're probably going to feel more sensation along the inner thighs. If you move them further away, you may feel this more in the outer hips, more in the outer thighs. Use the blocks if you need to. If your hips are still feeling tight and you're not able to fully relax, take an inhale to lift and lengthen. And exhale, fold forward. Maybe again, you take your bolster or blocks or blankets or pillows, whatever you have to support your upper body as you come into your forward fold. These postures for several moments at a time, typically anywhere from 2 to 7 minutes. Generally, the asymmetrical poses are held for shorter periods of time. And the A are the symmetrical, such as this butterfly, we hold a little bit longer. So there's plenty of time to give your body an opportunity to feel its way into your shape, into sensation, into what feels right for you. Notice your breath. How does it feel? Have you been able to maintain a steady, rhythmic flow? Or does it feel short or shallow? And if you're having that short and shallow feeling in your breath, try to lengthen your inhales and your exhales. Identify whether the reason that that's happening is because you're exerting yourself too much. Maybe you need to back off a little bit. to come out of this, and a slow, complete exhale. And then inhale to begin to rise slowly. Move any props that you used in your butterfly out of the way. Straighten your legs in front of you and just give your feet a little bit flex here and then relax. Move your hands behind you as wide and as far back as you need to and let your chest adjust up toward the sky. You can lift your gaze up toward the sky as well, or you can drop your chin down toward your throat or let your head fall all the way back if that's comfortable for your neck. Just take a few breaths here, a brief counter to the forward folds. Press through the palms a little bit here to create and push through an arch in the lower back, lifting your chest further up toward the sky. And take a deep inhale and exhale. And then slowly, if your head dropped back, begin to bring it back upright and then walk the hands back up toward your hips. And then take a straddle with your legs, setting up for dragonfly pose. So you again decide how far do you want to take your straddle, and that's going to be different for everyone. You may want to have blocks underneath your knees. This is really helpful if you have tight hamstrings or your lower back is tight, or if you typically have trouble with these forward folds, getting the pelvis to tilt forward. If you don't use the blocks, maybe you just bring the soles of your feet to the ground, creating this really sharp angle in your knees. You might also, again, use your bolster or whatever you've got, pillows, to support your upper body as you begin to come into your forward fold. Take an inhale to lift and lengthen, and exhale, draw the upper body forward, and then eventually relax, release. Always remember that we're not trying to get into the deepest range of motion. You want to ease into your body. So I usually say in my classes, on a scale of 1 to 10, with 1 being the least amount of sensation and 10 being the most, aim for somewhere in the 2 to 5 range. Intent is not to collapse into the deepest end range of motion. Make your adjustments, come back to your breath, settle in. Sensation is, imagine you're a professional wine taster, and so you don't immediately gulp the wine and let it drop down into your throat. You kind of let it settle in your mouth, you swish it around, you roll it around, you notice the subtleties. And then and only then do you let it slowly ease down your throat. And then you're able to appreciate those subtle qualities in taste and sensation. Take a deep inhale. A complete and total exhale. And on your inhale, slowly start to walk your way back up. Set your props aside if you were using them. Make sure that you've got easy access to them if you need them. Slide off of the blanket if you were sitting on top of it, or a pillow, whatever you were sitting on top of, and then slowly come down to your back. Now, once you arrive on your back, just let your body go. Release all of the sensation from your body. You may feel some lingering and residual sensation in your lower spine. That's totally normal. This will begin to diminish as you settle into rebound. And just feel what you've stirred up in your body. Notice your breath. Notice the state of your mind, your emotions. Soles of your feet to the floor or your mat. Grab your bolster, or maybe you've got a couple of blankets or some other type of bolster that you've created. Lift your hips, slide the bolster underneath your sacrum. And once you've got the bolster situated, get it right underneath the sacrum. Adjust your upper body, and then slowly begin to straighten both legs down to the ground, coming into a floating bridge. Close your eyes, hold your breath. Feel like this is too much for your lower back, having the legs extended in front of you, then just bring the soles of your feet back to your mat. And widen your feet, let your knees collapse together. If you're someone whose knees don't connect in this shape, just place a block in between them so that your legs are able to relax. Up closer to your shoulders or to your ears. Maybe you bring the lower arms above the top of your head, clasp opposite wrists or elbows, or clasp your fingers. Stay here with your legs extended in front of you, or if you've taken the option of widening the feet and letting the knees collapse, you can inclined butterfly, bringing the soles of the feet together, letting the knees open to the sides. If you feel like you need the support, blocks underneath the knees, underneath the thighs, wherever you feel like you need that additional support. Deep inhale, slow, complete exhale, and start to bring yourself back up into that supported bridge version, and then take a moment to let your head rock to one side, and then over to the other side, and do that again. Rock your head over to one side, and then over to the other side. And let your arms come back down toward your waist. Lift your hips slowly, and then slide the bolster from underneath your body. Come back down to the ground. Straighten your legs in front of you. Yourself onto your belly. And just let your forearms cross above your head. Rest your forehead or one side of your face on top of your palms. Rested one side of your face, switch to the opposite. Then you can bring your head back to center and come up to your forearms for Sphinx Pose. So in your Sphinx Pose, again, if you've got the bolster, consider moving the bolster underneath your upper body to give yourself some support, just bringing the forearms in front of the bolster. You might also grab your blocks or books or whatever you've got in place of blocks and position them in a way according to height to rest your forehead on, to support the weight of your head, which is going to let your upper body relax So in the Yin Sphinx, most important is to relax your lower body. And you might additionally widen your legs or bring your legs closer together according to how much sensation you're feeling in your lower back. So generally, the wider your legs are, the less compression that you'll feel in your lower spine. And as far as your upper body, you're perfectly welcome to keep some engagement here, but it's also okay to just let your upper body go. Let the shoulders relax. They may shrunk up toward your ears. This is okay. You can either prop yourself up onto your bolster, so your forearms are propped on top of the bolster, or if you prefer, you can take this into a seal pose, pressing through the palms to lift and straighten your arms for full seal. Make sure when you transition to either of those two variations, if you do, to bring your attention back to your lower spine, your lower body, and release once again. Those of you who took seal pose, you may find after a few seconds that, no, that's not going to work for me. So maybe you bring it back down to those milder variations, either forearms propped on top of your bolster, or you just come back into your Sphinx pose. Exhale. And then very slowly. you to push yourself up and back into a child's pose. And as you start to ease into child's pose, you decide whether you want to keep your knees together, which is going to give some nice stretching to your lower spine, or keep your knees apart, which is going to provide some more gentle opening to the upper body. Take a deep inhale and exhale completely. And inhale to start to rise out of your child's pose, coming back to sit briefly on your heels, shift your hips over to one side, bring your legs in front of you, and then adjust yourself on the floor, on your mat, so that you come back to a reclined position. Again, another opportunity to feel the rebound. Another way to think of that is to notice what resonates in your body. Once again, bring the soles of your feet to the floor, to your mat. Separate the feet wide, separate the knees wide, and then let both legs drop over to the left. Maybe you start to bring the arms up closer to the shoulders, the ears coming into rotation here. I personally like to have something in between my legs to support me so that this is as effortless as possible. And then decide what to do with your arms. It doesn't really matter. It just matters what is most comfortable for you. You can let them fall above your head. You can let your head fall in one or the other direction, whatever feels good for your body, and then come back to your breath. twist and take it over to the opposite side, bringing the legs up and letting them drop over to the right. Come back to your breath. Back up to center, and then move anything out of the way that was supporting you. Straighten your legs down to the ground. If you need to break your position in order to grab a blanket, cover yourself up. Do that, and then come into a final relaxation position. Let your head move a little bit side to side. Adjust yourself in any way that you need to, and then settle into stillness. And let all sensation go. Feel only the weight of your body become heavy. Breath remain steady and rhythmic. Mind calm and at peace. deepen your inhales and lengthen your exhales. Take a few active rounds of breath and then start to move your body in slow, small ways. Gradually growing these movements into larger movements and actions. And when you're ready, you can start to bring yourself back up into a seat. Maybe you want to bend your legs, bring the knees into your upper body for a moment. Let yourself sway side to side, move the head around, move the hips around, and then eventually rolling yourself over to one side, and then slowly pressing yourself up into your seat. See if you can keep your eyes closed on your way back up.